There you go.
There he is.
Turn the computer.
Hi, Wine Merchants team. Welcome to another episode of Apericena. Today, Stefano and I are going to be joined by a very special guest. His name is Brian. He comes to us from the Kowalski's chain. We're going to ask him a few questions. He's going to talk a little bit about some wines that he really likes for spring. And we're going to drink some great wine that he likes from our portfolio along with him. So without further ado, Brian.
Here we go. So rosé for the summer, right? And mostly some Italian whites. The second question here that we have, Cab is still the king in retail.
Yes.
And do you see any wine that would surpass or, take over it?
The short answer is no. I've been doing this since the early 90s, and Cab has been king that entire time. You know, occasionally, I hate to say fads, but trends will nibble away at a little bit of its market share. You know, we saw, Merlot in the 90s or Malbec, or, we've seen Fane spike for a few years during that time. And There's always new and fun and different that comes along, but in terms of knocking Cabernet off the hill, I do not see that. I don't see one grape that really brings to the party that everything that Cabernet has, which is everything a lot of consumers tend to like, that's really going to take its place.
For sure. It's almost got a brand built for itself. You have an idea in your mind of what you're going to be getting in your glass. I think that consistency has helped it stay in its place, whereas Pinot Noir doesn't always have that consistency as a red.
Which is too bad. I mean, I wish you could, because there really are, whether it's Petit Syrah or, Carmenere or there's some old vine Carignans out there or something. There are just some tea staining bruisers out there that I think give Cab absolutely a run for its money.
If you're going to convert somebody away from Cabernet, you get one shot. What are you taking them to?
So a lot of times that just depends on what I have on hand or kind of what I'm excited about that's kind of new and interesting. And my first question is usually, is this for food or is this just for sipping, all by itself? But depending on the answer, that might send me, I could recommend a big, more fruit-driven Petit Syrah, or if they are burning steaks on the grill, I wouldn't hesitate to give one of those old vine Carignans or Carmenere. Being a grocery store wine shop, most of the wines we select have a certain accessibility. I won't say they're not all immediate gratification, but nobody wants to hear how great that wine is going to be in 4 years. They're taking it home to yank the cork tonight. And so we want wines that express themselves, pretty well when they're young, but aren't clumsy or too fruit driven. We still like balance and authenticity and typicity. I need a wine that tastes good tonight.
So how do you take that buying philosophy and use it to set yourself apart from other places that people go to buy wine?
I don't know. Like I said, we're first and foremost, we're looking for authenticity. There's a lot of grocery retailers or retailers in general that just sort of skew more towards the top 100 brands. That is, couldn't be further away from what we do. We're looking for the best wines we can find. Now, that said, we are a grocery store retailer, and the vast majority of our selection is under $20. I don't have a lot of folks who come in from the grocery store with a frozen pizza under their arm who want Barolo. If they do, we've got it. We're looking for quality. The nicest thing anybody can say to me is I've never bought a bad bottle of wine here.
Well, that's why you buy from us.
That's exactly right. That's why Wine Merchants is my number one supplier.
So speaking of Italy, what are you enjoying from Italy right now?
I like Italy from top to bottom. You know, this is one of my, you know, we've been working with this now for, what, three years probably. Our stores aren't very big. And so we rotate when something loses momentum or it's just sort of lost popularity because everybody's seen it, then we tend to move, you know, we move on. But this has been around for years just because the quality is so stunning for the money. So I love Sardinia.
All right, Wine Merchants team, thanks for joining us for part one of Brian's interview. He selected a few wines from our portfolio that he's really excited about and that he would like to have us share with you. The first wine we're going to talk about is Cantina Mesa Vermentino. Stefano, you want to give us a quick rundown of that wine and that winery?
Yeah, absolutely. I knew he was going to pick this wine because he never had something like that. This wine has all what he likes. It's unique. Is mineral, salty, a wine that can go with a nice meat or with the fish, a wine that can age. You can have this wine for 2, 3, 4 years. First of all, the name, Cantina Mesa Vermentino Giunco. We had this from Santa Margherita just recently. It is a winery that is based on the southern west corner of Sardinia. And it's in a bay, in a particular area, it's called Sulcis. And the Sulcis area is a very unique area with a very specific microclimate, like an open line from that goes from Sardinia to Spain, that kind of a direct wind through that particular bay that mitigate the climate. This vineyard is facing the sea. So when you're tasting this wine, the first things that you really can notice is the saltiness. This is not citrus, it's salty. The good part is that we are able to get this wine here in USA. Their distribution was so limited. And actually it was funny because when I was presenting this wine in an event, a couple of Italians came. And they says, wow, that's the wine that we used to drink when we go in Sardinia. So it's a wine that it's very well recognized. For sure, if you want to bring something particular to your customer, this one is one.
All right, thanks for joining us this week, Wine Merchants team. Join us next week for part two of our interview with Brian. Hope to see you then.
See you guys. Just remember, stay healthy, and I'll see you on the next one. It's that time of the day. Last week we got by without much exercise. This week I gotta do, it's pretty hard. I gotta do some push-up. I have to get some assistance. Before you start stretching this way, you do this 3 times. I don't need because I do this every time.
You're fresh.
To do push-up, I need assistance by my son that is gonna hold the computer. Come here. Now I'll go down and then you're gonna film me, okay? Okay. Repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. That's enough. Oh, God.
That was good. What was that, 40 in a row?
I don't know. I usually don't count. I just go with my, you know, the... God, that was hard.